fighting machine. Another came, and another, striding over hills and trees, plunging far out to sea and blocking the exit of the steamer. Between them lay the silent, grey, ironclad Thunderchild. Slowly it moved toward shore, then with a deafening roar and whoosh of spray, it swung about and drove at full speed towards the waiting Martian.
There were ships of shapes and sizes scattered out along the bay, and I thought I heard her calling as the steamer pulled away.
Nothing was left now to fight them. The Earth belonged to the Martians.